Today we're doing the final review video for the Smarty Cat Bamboo Bunk, which Trig has just gotten into. So, as you can tell, Trig fits in it, but it's a little snug. I think that's probably the best way to put it. And as we all know, those of us who are wise cat owners, it does not matter if the cat fits or not. If the cat likes it, the cat will make sure he fits. He or she fits. So, I think Trig's 14 pounds. You know, sometimes the weight doesn't matter because they could be obese 14 pounds or they could be a fit 14 pounds. It's more really their body style. So for a large breed cat like Ragdolls, I would say Trig is about average. So this pillow right here goes in that slot where Trig is right now, but I removed it when I started filming just now, and so he got in it regardless. Trig's very attracted to it, and has I have caught him in it. He does prefer some other beds over it, but it might be one of those things where we have too many options and we need to eliminate our options so that I can see if he really would only choose it. So let's look at some things about it. Hi. I know you hate when it... So it's got this little feather thing that hangs down, and that's on a elastic pole. So if they want to bat that around, they can. My cats have played with it, but they haven't played extensively to the point where it would concern me. But if they did play with it too much, I would probably just cut that off, because I'd hate for something to happen when I wasn't at home with that. But I think overall it's been totally fine. They kind of, you know, it amuses them for a good 15 seconds and then they're done with it. What else? I did an assembly video of this, literally raw, of how to put it together. I think I'm going to put that at the end of this video so that I don't have to link to the other one. But I think it took around 2 minutes and 30 seconds to put this together. It's all Velcroed, as you can tell. And so these two rings are separate, and then this mat Velcros onto the two rings that have the Velcro on them, and then the base has Velcro that the mat, and then the mat Velcro matches the base, and then it has these two pulls. So it was incredibly easy to set up, and I think it's really good looking. I mean, it is a fancy cat bed in the sense of the look of it. It's very different. It's not like anything I've seen. And I like that there's 3 entrance points, but then they have that back where they can feel secure. What else? Tiggy? Tiggy, you freaking... Oh, I don't think that this part is washable, but I would think that it's wipe-offable. It's kind of a velvety material. And then this bed is super soft. I've never touched anything so soft. When my sister was, well, maybe Camus. Maybe Camus is comparable to this. But when my sister was filming the video of me putting it together, that was the first thing that she did when she stopped filming, was touch the bed because I had said how soft it was.
Are you doing? You're trying to scratch in the ears? I don't know if that's a scratching spot. Tick-doo. Tick-doo, maybe they could redesign and put that scratching on the inside. Tick-doo. Tick-doo, tick-doo.
So, looks like I could leave this pillow out and Trig wouldn't mind. The weight limit is 25 pounds. And I would think you could even use this for a dog. I mean, you might want to get rid of the feather thing. But the feather thing's kind of fun. Just like, that's how Trig and Charlie have been playing with it. Like how Trig is now, kind of like, oh, I'll bite you. Oh, you're in my way. You're hitting me.
Kim Teague!
So from what I can tell, the Smarty Cat Bamboo Bunk is sold at Walmart, Target, and they're different prices online, so you could just go to Walmart or Target and see if you could find it there. The prices online vary quite a bit, from like $26 to $39.99. This is the first time I've had this bamboo bunk bed down here in the basement, and Trig is very attracted to it in the basement, which is good. He was actually sleeping in our usual downstairs fleece bed and then came over to get in this.
What are you doing? Why are you so fun? I like you.
So that is it. I would recommend this bed to someone who's looking for the style of bed. When I did the video of me putting it together, some people mentioned that it looked a little bit too small for ragdolls, but I can't even say that I wouldn't recommend it for ragdolls, because Trig likes it, and we've got other pet beds that are small, but, you know, if the cat likes it, what is it, something like, if I fits, I sits, something like that. There's some viral photo of a cat that floats around from, like, I Can Has Cheeseburger, I think, talks about if I fits, I sits. So I'm going to put this back real fast. I'm going to put this right there. Oh, thanks. That's the other thing, is the pillow takes up a little bit of the space on the inside, so you could always take that pillow out. It is really super soft, though. But Triggy shows you how it's done. So Charlie is also 14 pounds, but he's just a bigger built cat. So I asked him to get in there. He's very reluctant about this right now. Charlie is not a cat that likes enclosed spaces. He's more like a dog, likes to be out in the open, runs to the door when people come. So as you can tell from his slightly annoyed flick of a tail, he's not terribly pleased with my request to be in there, but that gives you an idea. He tried to lay down fully, but then he couldn't get himself situated to do so. He is interested in it, but he just is not going to want to be in it, because he's not an enclosed type cat. For example, Trig likes to sleep in a bed that's completely enclosed, only one exit point, and Charlie sleeps on top of the cat power tower, totally exposed to everything. So, again, you just need to know your cat on whether or not they're going to like this kind of a bed. But he's kind of pooped.
But did you have a busy day outside today? You did? Oh, wumboo.
All right, thank you so much for watching our video. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Helps our channel grow, helps me bring you more reviews like this one, and we'll see you next time. Okay, today I'm putting together this Smarty Cat Bamboo Bunk, and I wanted to do a video on how to put it together. This is my first time putting it together, so if you're concerned about doing it yourself, hopefully this will alleviate any of that.
Ooh, this is so soft, lovers.
That's so soft. Well, I don't see any instructions. That's... oh, Jiminy. oh, yeah.
Oh, it's just sticky. I see it now.
Okay. I don't know, Bubby. This is kind of hard. Oh, there are the instructions. Aha. All right. So we want to wrap the bamboo thing. So you just line up the, these oval rings with the bamboo mat, and it's all Velcro, as you can see.
But with it!
And then, these little poles go in here. This little pole. This is a really quick setup, actually. It's quicker than I thought it would be. And then, there's Velcro on here that you line up there. And there. And there we have it. Alright. This pillow, by the way, is super, super soft. It reminds me of a baby blanket. It's so soft. Alright, now we just need a cat. I also didn't secure this as much as I would have. This is just a test run, so I'm gonna see if I can get him in there.
That's good.
Shoot out the other side.
It's okay. It's okay in there. How you doing there? You gonna play with that one? You can. We'll play with that one. Oh, but Amy doesn't have an iPhone. iPhones are scary, but Amy doesn't have an iPhone. Hey, think. What do you think? That's a teddy bear? I'm thinking that's a teddy bear. And so.